met a most terrible fate.
Originally, Barney started off in this map in the doorway down by the citizens, but playtesters tended to wander around for a while before stumbling across him. We moved him up.
I don't think this war's ever gonna end.
Originally, Barney started off in this map in the doorway down by the citizens.
Defend the citizens! Get them to the trains!
Doing good. Well, that wasn't so hard. We should have brought everyone over at once.
Take these folks to the train and keep them safe.
Freeman, ammo!
I don't dream anymore. Here, take this med kit. Here, have a med kit. Okay, they're safe. Go for another group.
Thank you.
Fantastic ass kicking cock!
Combine!
I'm safe.
We've got you covered. Your head's dead, 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 dead. We're ready for another group of citizens.
Make sure you get there safe and sound. Defend the citizens! Get them to the trains!
That should keep them off our backs for a while.
You guys coming?
Go on, Barney. They're not after you. Gordon and I will draw their attention while you get the others away from here. We can grab another train once you're clear.
Okay, then. But don't take too long about it, yeah?
Here, let's open up this next track.
We needed a train station, but we didn't want something that was too similar to the one in Half-Life 2. We decided to give this station a more industrial look, to make it a place where trains were repaired and freight was offloaded. We included some combine elements to help explain why the Strider can't fire through the various strategic barricades required by the game design.
For this climactic battle, we created a new AI that makes the Strider a more interesting opponent. It has a snappier cannon attack, can better track the player's movements, and it now has the ability to target the environment in dangerous ways. For instance, its cannon fire can shove heavy shipping containers straight to the player.
We often use goodies, such as this crate and the scanner battery around the corner, to guide players along a preset route. We want players to hit their marks during a battle without drawing attention to the fact that they're being subtly manipulated down a particular path.
We wanted to keep the tension high in this fight, but we also realized that players would need some cover. These destructible panels satisfied both those design goals. Effectively, they're time sheltered. Players can hide behind the panels, but the Strider will target them until they're destroyed. This gives the players brief periods of safety during which they can plan their next move.
Along with Vistas, positive feedback from Alex is one of our primary means rewarding players.
In this case, Alex's excitement over the Strider's destruction adds a sense of closure to
the train the player rides out of City 17 had two major design goals. It had to visually connect the end of Episode 1 to the beginning of Episode 2, and it also needed to address some functional gameplay.
Apart from being a big visual payoff to the episode, there were several story requirements that this ending sequence needed to convey. It had to make it very clear that the Citadel was destroyed, that the Citadel pods had escaped, and it needed to imply that the data transmission beam was streaming out of the ruins. We discovered that Alex had to be mostly silent during the scene, or else players tended to look at her instead of all the chaos around them.